Now, come to the third type of relation, that is transitive relation. A relation R in a set A is said to be transitive if and only if AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R implies that AC belongs to R. Suppose R is a relation in a set A and A contains A, B, C, D and many elements. And if in relation R, if AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, then if AC is also belonging to R, then the relation is said to be transitive relation. Let us take an example. Suppose R is a relation in set A, where suppose A contains elements 1, 2, 3 and 4 and R contains ordered pair 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 4, 3, 4, then what ordered pair must come in relation R so that it will become transitive? Here you can see 1, 2 belongs to R and 2, 3 belongs to R. According to definition, if AB belongs to R and DC belongs to R, then AC must belongs to R. Here 1, 2 belongs to R and 2, 3 belongs to R, then 1, 3 must belongs to R. Moreover, here 2, 3 belongs to R and here 3, 4 belongs to R, then 2, 4 must belongs to R. So now this relation becomes a transitive relation. Now what is equivalence relation? What is equivalence relation? Now you know what is symmetric relation, what is reflexive relation and what is transitive relation. If a relation R is reflexive, symmetric and as well as transitive, then the relation R is said to be equivalence relation. So, the relation R is said to be equivalence relation if it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Now let us take an example in which the relation is an equivalence relation. It means the relation should be reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Suppose A is a set of lines in a plane and R is a relation and is a relation defined as R contained or ordered pair L1 L2 such that L1 is parallel to L2. Now let's check whether this type of relation is equivalence relation or not. First property, we will check its reflexivity. Here we can see that A is a set of all lines in a plane. And for reflexive, we know that a relation is said to be reflexive if for each element which belongs to set A, it must relate it to itself. So, for each L belongs to A, LL belongs to R. Why? Because the relation L1 L2, what it says, a relation is L1 L2, it says L1 is parallel to L2. And it is reflexive for each element belongs to A, any line which is contained in a set A, LL belongs to R. Why? Because every line is parallel to itself. Symmetric. Here R is symmetric also. For every L1 L2 belongs to A. If L1 L2 is belonging to R, this implies L2 L1 must belongs to R. Where L1 L2 are contained in A. Why? If L1 L2 belongs to R, this means L1 is parallel to L2. Then why L2 L1 belongs to R? Because if L1 is parallel to L2, L2 is also parallel to L1. Line 2 is also parallel to L1. So, if this belongs to R, this must be belongs to R. So, relation R is symmetric also. Now, check the third condition. Transitive. If L1 L2 belongs to R and L2 L3 belongs to R, this implies L1 L3 belongs to R, where L1 L2 L3 are contained in set A. Now check, if L1 L2 belongs to R, it means line 1 parallel to line 2, and L2 L3 belongs to R, it means line 2 is parallel to L3. Then L1 L3 must also belongs to R, because if L1 is parallel to L2 and L2 is parallel to L3, then L1 is definitely parallel to L3. So here you can see A contains set of lines in a plane and R is a relation which is defined as L1 L2 belongs to R, where L1 is parallel to L2, then it is reflexive, symmetric as well as transitive. So here, in this given example, this relation R is an equivalence relation. Since R is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive, so relation R is an equivalence relation. Now, I think you must understand about what is equivalence relation.